Hi all, I am Yufei Xing, corresponding author of the paper entitled A Compact Hardware Implementation of CCA-Secure Key Exchange Mechanism, CRYSTALS-KYBER on FPGA. This work was done in 2020 when I was pursuing a doctoral degree in Tsinghua University, China, and Shuguo was my supervisor. It is about a full hardware implementation of KYBER aiming at compact design with decent performance in a limited number of butterfly units. The background of our work is the crucial threat of powerful quantum computers to public key crypto systems currently used in our daily life, with which mathematical hard problem, integer factorization, discrete logarithm that considered to be infeasible to handle with classic computer architecture now can be broken in polynomial time by Shor's algorithm. As a result, NIST launched a contest of new post-quantum cryptographic schemes and called for proposals from all over the world in December 2016. And there are 7 finalists and 8 candidates remained in the third round of contest. In NIST's current view, structured lattice appear to be the most promising ones. The motivation of our work is the urgent need for full hardware reference implementation of finalists in PQC contest to demonstrate their potential strengths and intrinsic property. From such works, we can find bottlenecks in the way towards high-speed or low-cost designs on hardware platform. Many previous works presented the results of hardware-software co-designs. The most computationally intensive procedures are offloaded to coprocessor to speed up computation. Entity and catch-all call are typical modules of such type, while other parts of our protocol mainly tasks not convenient to be handled with hardware design are left over to processor, such as ARM Cortex series or RISC-V cores. Because components like entity and catch-all call are commonly used in lattice-based cryptography implementations, these co-designs can be developed in a relatively short period of time. And another important benefit is that they are not sensitive to minor changes of protocol parameters. However, the flexibility comes at the cost of low performance, and dedicated hardware design are much more preferable in pursuit of high performance. We select KYBER as our research target. It is a MLW-based key exchange mechanism proposed by CRYSTALS team and is one of the 7 finalists in PQC contest. Here is the algorithm description of key generation phase of KYBER. The main procedures include sampling and entity-related calculations in polynomial multiplications. Several auxiliary procedures are listed as well, applying to random bits or intermediate results. Our start point is to come up with a proper way to arrange the order of sampling and entity-related procedures to save cycles. Besides, the entity calculation in KYBER is different from that in normal lattice-based cryptography protocols, and there would be some space to carry out optimization. Together with a proper Fujisaki-Okamoto transform implementation, a compact design with decent performance can be expected. As there is no 2n primitive root of unity in field ZQ, the cyclotomic polynomial modulus would not factor into 2n linear polynomials, but not n quadratic polynomials. KYBER adopts NTT in polynomial multiplication. Then both polynomial multiplicands should be evaluated at specially selected points. Then two facts follow. The first fact is the evaluation process actually divides into two parts, the part with even indexed coefficients and the part with odd indexed coefficients. They can be conducted concurrently, and the Twiddle factors are shared between the two parts. The second fact is the pointwise multiplication is between 2 linear polynomials, not 2 numbers, and 5 multiplications in field ZQ would be involved in a straightforward implementation way. noticing the constant term and linear term coefficient is separated naturally. CRYSTALS method can be exploited to decrease the total number of small multiplications. In such a way, the linear term of result is rearranged to make use of intermediates during constant term calculations. And one multiplication in field ZQ can be decreased, saving cycles potentially. From the two facts above, the natural idea is to exploit two butterfly units, each responsible for even or odd part of polynomial during NTT or NTT. While during pointwise multiplication, they cooperate with each other such that four multiplications involved can be done in two cycles. With rearrangement of NTT, the pre-scaling and post-scaling procedures can be absorbed into NTT calculation. And the Twiddle factors now should be replaced with product of original Twiddle factor and part of the scaling factor. Accounting for the two auxiliary procedures, a unified butterfly structure is adopted. With one multiplier and the adder subtractor ahead of and behind it, several procedures can be adapted to this structure. In addition to normal use in NTT and INTT, it can complete one pointwise multiplication in two cycles, denoted as PWM0 and PWM1. Compress and decompress procedures are supported as well. Several procedures can be rearranged and merged to save cycles potentially. For example, the addition with E'' in calculation of V can be deferred into adjacent calculation of C2. In such way, both calculations can be supported by the unified butterfly structure. It should be noted the sign of each element in E'' should be negative, which is easy as we can simply negate the sign of each bit in constructing centered binomial distributed samples. In addition to noise samples at the base centered binomial distribution, the public matrix A should be sampled uniformly in field ZQ. They both come from pseudo-random bits from catch-all core with different instantiation parameters. As sponge structured SHA-3 standardly is selected from candidates in contest, much like the PQC contest, there are many hardware implementations that can be referenced. In our design, a play implementation of catch-all core is adapted, with input-output width adjusted to 32 bits and absorb function added. It completes one round of catch-all F function per cycle, and 50 cycles are needed to shift 1,600-bit inner state out. In total, 79 cycles are needed in one XOF, KDF, PRF, GH function in Kyber. Four XOF invocations are needed to generate one element polynomial in public matrix with overwhelming probability. In total, 316 cycles. One PRF invocation is needed to generate one noise polynomial when eta equals 2, and two PRF invocations are needed when eta equals 3. In a MLW-based protocol, the multiplication between public matrix and noise polynomial vector, as well as between two polynomial vectors, can be divided into small polynomial multiplications naturally. Each 256 term polynomials would be transformed to point value representation, consuming 448 cycles using two butterfly units. The input data vector comes from catch-all core and written into RAM block in 64 cycles. In total, 512 cycles are needed to complete forward NTT. Similarly, 576 cycles are needed, of which 448 cycles are for NTT calculation, the other 128 cycles are for compress function. The pointwise multiplication between two polynomials would take 256 cycles. We would arrange the order of sampling and entity calculation on the basis of these figures. Comparison between cycle counts of different calculations is needed, and the execution order can be adjusted accordingly. The main principle is to generate necessary data strictly before they are required by the entity call, and the entity calculations should be arranged properly, suited with execution order in the protocol. With all these facts above, we give out a manually adjusted concrete execution order of sampling and entity calculation. The total cycles consumed is determined by the butterfly units, and basically, sampling is hidden behind entity calculation. When more butterfly units are exploited, a higher input-output rate of catch-all call is expected, and the execution order can be adjusted in a similar way. Noticing the manually adjusted sampling order is irregular, and the conventional state machine would involve complex control logic. A predefined order table is more suitable here to store sampling order. And whether a noisy polynomial or public matrix element polynomial should be generated currently is determined by the fetched bit from order table. Within the table, there are four kinds of sampling, namely public matrix element polynomial sampling, represented with four consecutive zeros, and noisy polynomial when eta equals 2 is represented with figure 1. Noisy polynomial sampling when eta equals 3 is represented with a pair of 2 and 3. Implying two PRF functions should be invoked sequentially. Our catch-all call is working in an autonomous way, that whenever I-FIFO is not empty and it has done the last hash, data would be fetched from I-FIFO until enough data has been collected to begin the next hash process. Different instantiations of SHA-3 standards have different rate R and different capacity C, determining the number of bits that should be appended. The 2-bit mode signal determines the number of 32-bit zero data chunks appended. For XOF function, mode signal is 0. It is concatenated with 3-bit 7, determining the end of capacity counter is 7. For PRF function, mode is 1. It is concatenated with 3-bit 7, determining the end of capacity counter is 15. The appending process would begin the next cycle 1-bit last signal is active, counting from 0 until capacity counter equals the end determined by mode signal. Then the catch-all call would begin to process data and generate output bits after 24 rounds of catch-all F function. The absorb signal is active when catch-all call should work in sponge mode. Or in other words, the output data from last invocation should be exclusive OR with input data in current invocation. From the top of our design, a set of registers is deployed, storing intermediate 256-bit values. Part of them are collected from catch-all call, while the restored message is collected from entity call. These registered values would be sent to catch-all call in appropriate time. The components in dashed rectangle represent hash-related hardware modules. A FIFO is inserted ahead of catch-all call to buffer 32-bit data input chunks, and the output of catch-all call can be either sent to register set as aforementioned or regulated and sent to entity call as pseudo-random input bits. The pseudo-random data would be processed in entity call, and the generated output would be sent to encoder, regulated into 32-bit data chunks before transmitted to the other participant of the protocol. On the other hand, 32-bit data chunks from the other participant would firstly be buffered into I5, decoded into points with proper length, then transmitted to entity core to take participate in calculation. Several FIFOs are exploited in our design to buffer data or serve as data storage, and the smallest configuration should be determined to decrease the overall resource consumption. For data buffer, it is determined by the largest leftover data. When continuous data fed in is at a higher rate than output data. For data storage, it is determined by the largest data pile it would store at all times. The Fujisaki Okamoto transform contains re-encryption and comparison procedure in server side. Noticing the polynomial vector t in public key is required in re-encryption, and the ciphertext C1 and C2 are both required in comparison after they participate in decryption process. They should not be thrown away before the transform is conducted. Actually, there is no need to resort to extra storage resource. For polynomial vector t, it is redirected to input port of O5O when transmitted to client. For ciphertext C1 and C2, they are redirected to input port of D540 and D541 respectively. When they are fetched by entity core to take participate in decryption process. With all the methods above, a compact design with decent performance is achieved. Compared with related hardware designs at that point of time, our work is not the fastest. The work in DFA20 is more than 2 times faster than ours, mainly because more computation units were exploited. The LUT, FF, BRAM, and DSP usage is more than 1.5 times, 2 times, 4 times, and 5 times more than ours. Compared with HHLW20, our design is more than 10 times faster, while the LUT, FF consumption is more than 10 times and 40 times less than theirs. Compared with hardware-software co-designs, our work is hundreds of times faster. These referenced works are all established on RISC-V soft core with different distribution. The resource consumption varies in a large range, from only a quarter of ours to more than 3 times of ours. It can be concluded that hardware-software co-designs are not good choices when performance is considered primary. CRYSTALS-KYBER is another finalist in the contest, and the parameters are very close to that in KYBER. Compared with the related hardware design of CRYSTALS-KYBER in RB20, the timing performance of our design is pretty close to that in RB20, while the LUT and FF consumption is more than 3 times and 2 times less than the design of CRYSTALS-KYBER. The compactness comes from mainly 3 aspects. The first is storage reuse, as aforementioned in Fujisaki Okamoto transform, and proper arrangement of execution order in KYBER, such that most intermediate results are consumed just after they are generated, and pseudo-random bits generation follows the just-in-time strategy. The second is 2 multipurpose butterfly units are adopted and can support all entity-related calculations in KYBER, making full use of the multipliers. The third is the input-output process of catch-all call is conducted through shift of inner set queue without resort to a dedicated downshift register. As a result, the catch-all call is not ready for the next hash before output bits are fetched and input bits are fed in completely. A full invocation of catch-all function would take 79 cycles, much larger than the theoretic 24 cycles. It would not cause any trouble in our design, as the generation rate of random bits can satisfy need of entity core. The decent performance of this architecture is achieved from mainly two aspects. The first is we arrange execution order properly, such that sampling procedures are almost hidden behind entity-related calculations. And the second is several procedures are rearranged, merged, and allocated in the unified butterfly structure, rather than conducted separately, saving total cycles. In pursuit of higher performance design, more butterfly units should be exploited, and the catch-all core should keep up with the random data requirement from butterfly units. Ideally, the adjustment of input-output width can be adequate, otherwise a higher speed catch-all core is needed, implying the resource consumption would increase significantly. In our design, the adapted catch-all core consumes 40% LUT, 35% FF of the whole design. If a low-cost design is expected, the first thing is to select a low-cost catch-all core. Our design has been verified against KYBER's known answer test files, and the whole project has been uploaded to GitHub. That's all of my presentation. Thanks for listening.